Hello everyone. So in this session we are going to study about the incomplete dominance. In the last session we studied about the schematic representation and the cross whatever we studied. So that is one example for incomplete dominance, but today we are going to find a reason behind it, why the F1 generation offsprings are pink in color, pink color flower, why they produces the pink color flower. But in the first case, but in the monohybrid case, it was not like that. In the F1 generation, all the offsprings were tall, right? In the case one study, we also came to know the dominant nature or the dominant gene, it suppress the recessive gene. But here it won't happen. The dominant gene, it is not able to suppress the recessive gene. So we'll study the reason behind it. Suppose I just consider here, I'm writing a homologous chromosome here. A homologous chromosome having genes. Consider a gene, it is situated on the chromosome. So the point, the place where the gene is present, so that gene, the place is known as, the area is known as locus. All right, so this is one gene. Consider this is one gene. I'm mentioning and representing, or I'm labeling that gene as R. R is nothing but red color, a dominant gene. It represents the dominant gene. One more R I'll write here. This is also represents the dominant gene. So the two forms of genes are known as alleles. Don't get confused with the area and two forms of gene. So this area is known as locus, and two forms of genes are known as alleles. Always the genes occur in pair. So if in our what we studied in the last session, the snapdragon flower or the snapdragon plant, if the snapdragon plant, it is producing red color flower, it means in that plant it is having dominant genes. In dominant gene, it should be in homozygous condition, then only the snapdragon plant, it bears or it produces the red flower. The same plant where if it producing white color flower, in that plant, on the chromosomes, what type of genes will be present? Homozygous recessive genes will be present. If that plant having a recessive gene, so that represents the, or that plant produces the white color flower. Here, just concentrate this. This gene, it is responsible for the producing of, or the production of pigment, a highly colored pigment, the dominant gene. When it starts functioning, it results in the formation of red petals in the plant. But here, in the smaller, there will be no such pigments in the chromosome or in the gene. So results in the production of white color flower. So this is what the parents we selected in the for the cross, right? So pure breed, one more pure breed. We cross these gametes, these parents' gametes. What we got in the F1 generation, we got, so I'll write the same thing here. I'll take the chromosome, homologous chromosome. I'll write the gene here, naming that as capital R and capital R. So this is the offspring coming from these two parents. So this offspring, it produces pink color flower. Why so? Because it is having one dominant gene and one recessive gene, right? So what is the reason behind it? Why it is not able to suppress the recessive gene? Why it is not producing the red color flower though it is having the dominant gene, though it is producing the pigment, though it is releasing the pigment, highly colored pigment? So we'll find out the reason here. Consider this is the dominant gene or dominant one, dominant allele or normal allele. Which one? The capital R we have named here, no? Consider this as a dominant allele or normal allele, and consider this as a recessive allele or modified allele. Why it is modified? Because it is a recessive gene. It do not express its character in presence of dominant one. Due to certain changes present in this recessive gene, it suppresses itself, and it is known as modification. It brings some modification in the phenotype of the offsprings. That's why it become the modified allele. But this is the normal allele. We are finding the reason behind it. We are finding the reason why the F1 generation produces the pink color flower. So we have started by taking this as a dominant and recessive. In the dominant, capital R is present and it is producing the pigment, and this is the small r and it is not producing any pigment. So now, according to the first case, what we should get? First case means monohybrid cross. According to the Mendel cross, in the F1 generation, it should be the red color flower plant, but it is pink color. We'll find out the reason now. So coming to the study of functions of gene. So if we start studying the functions of gene, what is the function of gene? Though it is having the pigment, I'll write here. We are studying the functions of gene. I'm starting with the dominant gene. So what is the function of dominant gene or dominant allele or normal allele? It produces the normal enzyme which transforms the if this gene is producing the normal enzyme, it brings the changes. What changes? It results in the formation of substrate. If it has produced the normal enzyme, it is having the, what is that, substrate and one enzyme, that results in the formation of a product. Okay, so what product it is in the offsprings, or the whatever it is having in the gene, whatever it is having the pigment, it has to release. So that is the product of the normal gene or normal allele or dominant allele, or it is also known as unmodified allele. Keep that in mind. If this is the modified allele, this is also known as unmodified allele. How many labels we have given here? 1, 2, one more is unmodified allele. So this unmodified normal allele, it is producing the normal enzyme which brings the transformation, or which changes the reaction, or which takes the substrate, which transforms the substrate, results in the formation of it results in the formation of the same phenotype, whatever it is having in its parent. So that phenotype exhibits or express in the F1 generation. So this is the normal one, results in the formation of phenotype, the same phenotype. Same phenotype means the parent's phenotype. So that is the normal process. When the process is going on, this recessive gene also compensate with the dominant one. Compensate means it should have to produce the normal enzyme or less efficient enzyme. Let me write the functions of recessive gene this side. So here we are going to start the functions of genes. Which gene it is? It is the recessive gene. According to the first case one study, according to the monohybrid cross or according to the Mendel's experiment, this gene is compensating with the dominant gene. This gene means the out of seven contrasting character. So the recessive gene also produces the normal enzyme, so that in the combination of these two, the offspring, whatever the offspring releasing producing in the F1 generation, it resembles to its parent generation, parent one. Parent means whatever the dominant character it is the parent have, that parent character or that parent phenotype will be come in the F1 generation according to Mendel's. But in the incomplete dominance, it is not happening like that. So the mixing of color, it is taking place in the F1 generation. Why this mixing? Because, listen to me properly here, the recessive allele or modified allele or this recessive gene, it according to the assumed study estimation, like according to the study, the recessive gene, it produces three types of enzyme. Here it has produced only one type of enzyme, that is normal one, which brings the changes in the reaction which resembles to the parent. But the recessive gene, maybe it produces the normal enzyme or less efficient enzyme, maybe it produces the non-functional enzyme, or maybe it maybe produces no enzyme. So these are the three possibilities of recessive gene. According to Mendel, what he selected, the pea plant recessive gene, it was producing the normal enzyme or less efficient enzyme, so that the results, whatever it forms the reaction, whatever it forms the substrate or the product, it will be equivalent to the dominant one. When it become equivalent, the dominant gene, it can overtake or it can take that product, and with this product in the combination of these two, the offsprings results or the offsprings express or the offsprings resemble to its parent. What parent? Dominant character. The dominant character expresses. So that was the case one study or monohybrid cross or the Mendel's cross. But here in the incomplete dominance, the recessive gene, it is producing either non-functional enzyme or no enzyme, which doesn't bring the transformation in the substrate, which doesn't result in the formation of phenotype. If it is not producing any enzyme, if it is not compensating with the dominant allele, it doesn't express a complete phenotype. The dominant gene, it is not sufficient to express a complete phenotype in the F1 generation. So the results, so in the F1 generation, all the offsprings like having dominant R and recessive R, it results in the production of pink color flower. So that is the reason behind it. So that is because of the functions of gene present in the recessive gene. It is not producing the normal enzyme, or it is not producing any enzyme. Because of that, the dominant gene, it is not sufficient. The functions, whatever the functions it is taking place in its enzyme, it is not sufficient to express its phenotype. So that's all about the incomplete dominance. So with this, we'll move on to the next one. So after the incomplete dominance, we have one more case study. We have one more example in the inheritance of one gene, that is codominance. The codominance, the example to explain better for the codominance is human blood group. So that we'll study in the next session. So if you have any doubts regarding to this concept, just ask me. Let me tell you some important concepts related to that test. In the chapter number 2, study the or learn all the diagrams like structure of anatropous ovule, structure of microsporangium, or the mature anther or young anther, whatever is there in the PDF notes, what you have written in your notes, the diagrams, just learn it. The diagrams are very important. If you learn the diagram, you'll get 5 out of 5 marks. As the same thing, chapter number 3, here there also, we have 3 to 4 diagrams, male reproductive system and female reproductive system. And with that, what is that? The cycle we studied, the menstrual cycle, that graph, that is not important. I won't give that graphical representation which comes in the menstrual cycle, but the structure of sperm is important. Okay, so learn all the diagrams. If you have any doubts in regarding to the chapter 2 and chapter 3, one more thing I should tell, the one mark question and from chapter number 2 and chapter number 3, I don't know from which term or from which concept I'll select the one mark question. So read it properly so that you'll come with the complete full marks. Thank you.